Hello guys, welcome back to Darkness Rises new update review guys. Finally it's live the update, and in this update we have new events, Halloween events, new costume for Halloween. We have lots of improvements in rewards for PvP and also other areas. Also the class, the witch, okay, the witch got buffed, some buffs. You're gonna see some balance. They say they will balance. Actually, she got some buffs. I'm gonna check those also. So let's get started. First, let's see the new costumes and also the collection. So let's go. First, let's check the new, oops, sorry, here. So this is the new Halloween. Oh my gosh, just the stats, 35,000 attack. Let's see compared to this one. Yeah, it's higher. Okay, PV, so it has PV stats, guys. Oh, nice. Okay. Okay, not bad. It's not bad. Interesting. What is the weapon? The weapon, really cool. The weapon is really interesting. So, Count Dracula, something like that. Or some... how is called that dude from the Avengers, Doctor Strange, yeah, forgot. So those are the costume. Let's see the collection, costume collection that we can get. So we get for this one attack increase. Wow, attack increase lasts for 27 days. That's a lot of attack. And let's see the other ones that we can get from the new chests and what buffs we'll get. So we have the chaser set, which I need just one more, and this gives you HP boost. Okay, rash guard. Okay, rash guard, seriously, wet suit. Okay, this gives attack, so can attack. Wow. Okay, so this one gives critical activation. Okay, another damage related stat is good. And swimsuit gives defense. Swimsuit, I have none. This I need missing one. This I have only one piece. Okay. Okay, so we can complete those sets, hopefully. Let's see what else we got. We have the new background, Halloween. Let's check the events, guys. And then we're gonna check some other stuff. Fight for the top. Fight for the top, okay. So this one, let's see. We have again rank A++ armors. S polishes, again A++ armor, then accessories. Okay, the accessories are back, and the last reward S+ to S++. Okay, 2025 points last for 2 weeks. Okay, so plenty of time. How we gain the point from participating in duel? You get 25 points if you participate in team PvP, also 25 points, and from rank matches if you participate, 15 points. Then if you win, you get extra points. For example, in duels you get 35 points. So if you win one time in duel, that means you get 25 plus 35, that's 60 points. For team PvP you get 45, so that means you get how many? 70 points. And if you win also in rank matches, you get 45 points. So should be easy to complete this. The rewards are good, not bad. Let's see what else. Not hard to finish. Gear development. Okay, so in here we get gold essences, more S accessory polishes, and guys, wow, gems are back. Long time we didn't got gems in the events, and finally we get some gems. 3000 also, 3000 multiply with 7 characters, that's 21,000, if I'm, yeah, 21,000 gems, guys. That's a lot of free gems. Quite happy about this. Can't wait to get them. And how you can get, again, 2025 points, 150 points if you fuse S or S plus gear. Is the S plus plus included? Actually, no. 500 points, fuse rank S plus plus gear to get rank L gear. Oh my gosh, 500 points, that means if you do just 4 fusions, That means you get already, you finish this event. So very easy to finish this and get the 3000 gems plus the other rewards. Amazing. Enhanced gear, you get 5 points, so that means you'll need a bunch, like 400 enhancement materials, 40 points for refining and so on. Upgrading also gives you, so most of the things that you can do with the gear will give you points. And oh, don't forget, we get this Jack of Larter pumpkins, you're gonna see, because we need them, and Halloween event mission. So we need to collect 4500 and we get this. This one, guys, will give you crazy rewards. I'm gonna show you what you can get from this lucky Halloween chest. But you need to reach to spend 4400 of this Halloween Jack of Ladders. Okay, let's see the shop. Okay, gold. It's good that we're still getting gold. That's 10 million right there. Halloween style choice chest. Two of them. So you can choose a style. Which styles? Interesting. Maybe just the ones from this current Halloween. Rank S polishes are back. Clear tickets, good. Gold boost again, super good. Refined stones and S++ gear 1. Okay, that means in total from all characters 7. Okay, the rewards are not bad. Not bad, I would say. And you'll see, guys, just wait, because you're gonna see what else you can get. We have Halloween, what you can get from this lucky Halloween chest. Okay, so already saw this. Okay, so these are the events. I'm gonna explain more what you can get from that. The last chest, you need to spend 4500 pumpkins and what you can get from there. Next, let's see what else, guys. They improved the rewards in gold dungeon. Okay, so now you start from 100k, okay, at step 1, then 200k, 300k, 400k, 500k, 600k step 6, step 7 is 700k, and 800k step 8. Before we had I think only 6 steps, I'm not sure, and now we have 2 extra steps, I think so, or was also before. So that's good, guys. We get now 1600 million instead on 1200. It adds up, it's not a lot. In the future, I'm sure they will give more, but we get gold now from events consistently and from best way, definitely from co-op. But guys, related to co-op, they improved the gold gain, because you know we need gold, no? From Immortal Rides. If you go and check, let's see. So we get way more gold. Check this out, guys. It starts from lowest difficulty, 250,000 per each run, guys. And then very hard difficulty for Immortal Battle, 300,000. So definitely, guys, you will want to get, if you want to farm gold, imagine if you do 3 runs, let's see for the higher ones, the highest difficulty. One second, to see what's the max per run we can get. So now, this should be another Sanctuary of Death, let's see. Highest difficulty, so lowest difficulty 350, highest 400. Thousands. So guys, you can farm gold also from doing Immortal Rides. So if you do 10, that's 4 million gold. 4 million gold from here, from 10 runs. Is it possible? I think it's possible to do that. So that's, even if you do the lowest difficulty, you start from 250,000. So that's 2.5 million for 10 runs. And it's really good. So more ways to get gold, that's good. And that's not it. The rewards in all PvP content got some buffs. Let's see, rank matches, let me check if they added anything. I think they added daily win rewards. I'm not sure. No, rank matches is the same. Okay, so rank matches they didn't change, but what they change is duels, team PvP, guild versus guild, and others, we're gonna review all of them. Let's see, duels, what we get. Before, you know, in order to get SIP, now instead of winning, you just have to participate. Okay, you have to do more, okay. Like now, before, if we got 3 wins, we would have got 150 gems. And also they increase the gold gain. We get rank A, refined stone choice. And for 10 participation, guys, gear development choice chest. Select one of the following items: rank S weapon or armor polish, rank S weapon or armor accessory, refined stones, or and gold. Wow. Okay, so the rewards are better. And total gems that we gain is how much? 171. So 20 gems more per character. And we have to participate 7 times. But you say, okay, we have to do more. No, just participate, not to win. It's a difference. Because for me to win, especially with my weaker characters, sometimes it will take more than 10 runs. So 7 runs, I don't think with this you'll spend more time. Only if you were really good in PvP and you're getting those 3 wins just from 3 runs. So I think it's the rewards are better, in my opinion. Maybe they will add also auto on duels for the lazy people or people that don't have time. Let's see for... Oh, ranking. Let's see the ranking, if they change anything. Because somebody said like, oh, they take the gems out of ranking reward. Seriously, I don't think so. I didn't see anything that... See, they didn't take the gems from the ranking. So, don't worry, guys. Also, from winning streaks, we still have them. So, but we get more gems, and I think it's easier to get them because not everybody is good in PvP, and for some people to get 3 wins will take more than 7 runs, okay? Team PvP, let's see the rewards in here, because in here also we got more, let's see. Also same system, participation, not wins, 45 gems or more gold, 50k, essences. Skill development choice chest. Select one of the following skill points. So this is a good way also to get skill points, guys. Ultimate skill scroll chest. Ultimate skill, guys. So if you want to max your ultimate skill, you can get from here. You can choose either 50 skill points, either ultimate one ultimate skill scroll chest, or 10k gold. Also, we get refined stones, and the last, again, the development gear development choice chest, where you can get rank S weapon armor accessory polishes. We can get a rank S weapon armor accessory refined stones or 100k gold. So if you do 10 participation, not 10 wins, that's good. That means you can get how many, 7 characters, 7 of these chests daily. That's good. Another way to farm polishes and refined stones, because those are harder to get. So I don't know, I saw some people complaining, oh no, it's bad, now it's harder to get the rewards. No, the rewards are better and it's easier. Why people always complain? Oh my gosh. Okay, brawl didn't got the guild versus guild. And by the way, guys, you get now, if you are not, didn't join a guild and you want to join a guild, and you should join a guild, you get 1000 gems from doing that. And there is also the possibility to leave your current guild and rejoin it, and you still get the 1000 gems, but you lose the I think you lose the points, the guild points, I'm not sure exactly, but you lose the progress. So it's not a good option for players that stayed for a long time in that guild. In case you find out what you lose actually, guys, let me know. I don't want to use the guild coins because it's very important for the guild shop. But where? Okay, guild right? Oh, guild PvP. Okay. Also in guild conquest, we got some extra rewards. So trophy collection reward got also buffed. We get better rewards, more gold, see, up to 200k, refined stones, polishes, choice, rank A, gear rank reward, Also got buff we get now, gear development choices, check this out guys. So you start getting those from any, you just have to be in top 100 and you still get this and some gold. So that's good, another way to get S, polishes or refined stones or gold. That's good. Okay, what else? Let's see what else. Also for the other content, the guild conquest also got buffs, got some buffs. Where is the guild conquest? Oh, so I think the, I'm not sure exactly. Okay, let me see. I'm not sure where it is. So, as an idea, I think all the rewards are better. Let me check team PvP, guild ranking rewards. Okay, already checked that. And oh yeah, let's see. Okay, now let's talk about the buffs. Okay, conquest rewards. So the conquest also you can get now from conquest. If you do, I didn't know. Conquest, you can get rank L polish chest. Okay, so you can get the L polishes, guys, from doing the conquest. Don't forget about that. And let's see the changes. We need to read the patch notes for that. So let's go. Info. And I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. And also related to the chest for the event, patch notes. Let's see the patch notes really fast because there are more details in here. See, rank S. Oh, you get also rank S++ gear chest and 1000 gems from joining or de-joining a guild. Okay. Okay, here. Let's see. Already checked that. And that. Okay, so here, guild PvP ranking rewards. See, we got more rewards. Trophy, we check that. Okay, weapon improvement. Now we can see the description for the skills. You can... Okay, so character balance. Which PV basic combo damage will increase about 21%? 21% more damage. The witch. Which PV PvP skill damage will increase as shown below? So, uppercut from 270 to 320, oh my gosh, that's 50% increase in PV, okay, in PvP is the same. Overhand strike from 270 to 350, that's 70%, no, 80, sorry, just for PvE. Then, stinging lance from 270 to 320, that's 50, and also... In PvP this time also from 350 to 400, that's 50%, wow. Hot shot from 270 to 350 for PV, so that's how much, 80. And in PvP from 250 to 350, oh my gosh, that's 100%, wow, that's crazy for PvP guys. So hot shot. And Dominator also. From 300 to 350 for PvE and for PvP from 300 to 350, so 50%. We have also Toxic Chain, 260 to 400, oh my gosh, 140% increase, that's crazy. 250 to 300 for PvP, Death Grip, also 50% increase in PV and nothing for PvP. Lightning Slash from 260 to 350, oh that's another, how much, 190, my bad. Okay, and for PvP 50%, Warp Gate 50% for PvE, Frozen Spear 40% for PvE and 50% for PvP. And now the ultimates, tighten punishment for 1,120 to 1,450. Oh my gosh, that's insane. 104,000, that's how much? 330% more. Wow, that's for PvE only. PvP is the same, okay? And weapon storm from 1,000 to 1,350, so 350% for PvE. And here, conquest reward improvement, rank L polishers chest will be added to conquest victory rewards. See, right here, you can see for each region, you have those L polishers, you can get more with higher regions. And now, also immortalized, we already checked that. More experience from guild conquest. Raid rewards improvement. 6 types of runes below will now be obtainable as raid kill reward, guys. We get the PvP ones, PvP raid runes, guys, from raids, okay? See right there. Gold dungeon, we already saw that. Vending machine also. Now it has 2 times more items, so daily products quantity of vending machine will be doubled, and you can get S++ gear level 660 product now from vending machine, so we should try that now. Okay, let's see what else, because I'm gonna, we have to check. I'm gonna show you, because from this okay, let's go official site. And there are some Halloween costume added, Halloween event added. Let's check in here. This is the Halloween event, guys. So check this out. What you can get from lucky Halloween chests, those that you need to spend 4,500 pumpkins, you can get Halloween bronze chest and Halloween gold chest. What you can get from those, let's see, it's insane. Obtained Halloween chest can be opened with 50 Halloween pumpkins. Okay, so those that you obtain, you need 50 Halloween pumpkins. Halloween pumpkins you get from completing the events. And what you can get? Halloween bronze chest, you can get 500k gold, clear tickets 40, keys 50, trade tickets 10, gems, you can get gems, guys, 100, extraction ticket 1, time eater 100, pet souls, shiny minerals, S polishes chest 20, S refined stone chest 15, pet development berries, and S to S++ wing chest. That's from the bronze chest, Halloween bronze chest. And definitely those will drop more often. And from the gold ones, you can get 10 million gold, 150 clear tickets, keys 200, trade tickets 100, gems 500, guys, 500 gems, rank S++ gear chest 1, rank S pet eggs, pet berry choice chest, development berries, rank S polish choice chest 100, no way, bro, 100 choice chest S polishes, and 50 rank S refined stones choice chest. Oh my gosh, guys, this hope I will get lots of gold Halloween chest. I'm gonna do a separate video about the events, okay, where I'm gonna also test these rates and show you how you can complete faster. So yeah, this event is way better, guys, because this from here you can get, see, lucky Halloween chest, okay, you need to get to 4,500 points spent in here in Halloween event shop, okay. And then from that you get random those chests, either the gold one or the bronze one, and you saw what you can get from there. And you need to open them using these pumpkins, because you'll still have left lots of pumpkins. So I'm gonna check anyways in another video. Let me know, guys, what you think. I think this update is good, even if we didn't get L accessories or increased rates. Maybe I should check, maybe the rates are better to get L gear. So see you guys in the next video. Bye.